Hey, everybody, I'm here in Ukraine with my friend Lexo.
Hey, everyone.
He is a alumnus. God, I got follower, correct me my fucking English, of Tactical Response. And when this thing started, he sent me an email and said, hey, I'm going to Ukraine and thank you for the training. I said, like, hey, I just put my paperwork in. He said, holy shit. Email, text, boom, boom, boom. And he said, come here. And then we started, I started saying, hey, we're hearing this, we're hearing that. So let's talk about the misinformation about the Legion and the general misinformation about the whole damn thing. So wherever you want to start.
Again, a lot going on. Firstly, biggest misinformation I heard from you guys that, like, it was a lot of concerns. Again, a lot of, information that is absolutely it's absolutely just lie, straight up lie. Beginning, I don't know if you want to mention a few of them, and that the people are foreigners that are coming in, Russian stopping trains and, like, shooting everybody that has even military uniform, something like that, or Ukrainians rob people or foreigners and put you in the front line.
Everyone has been super nice to us. Super nice. Hey, I need a toothbrush. Here's a toothbrush. Hey, we need a towel. Here's a towel. Need some shampoo? Yeah. I don't need shampoo, but
there's a lot of support from the world. There are trucks and trucks, they're coming every hour to help almost every city in Ukraine. And it's really greatly appreciated by people of Ukraine. But again, because of that, it's possible to have supplies, everything that help that people need this every day. Everyday things that really it's make people lives very, very comfortable.
Hey, come on over. You don't have to be anonymous.
Yes, he did.
He just left.
Literally, a guy from Anonymous here, and they just sent out 60,000. Text to Russia or something like that.
More, I think.
They've been hacking the Russians, sending them correct and truthful information about what's going on. And so one of the big things I kept hearing is the Russians are going to surround Kyiv in one day, in 2 days, in 3 days. Oh, my friend in the special forces or my friend in the army. Well, my friend in the intel says this is what's going to happen. I'm like, how the fuck do they know? It's all bullshit. There's a constant rumble of thunder, but that thunder is outgoing artillery. And I love it, man. I love it. But Ukraine is not only are they not beaten, not only are they not on the ropes, they're in the ring and Russia hasn't even really stepped up to the fucking fight yet.
I agree.
They're getting their ass handed to them. What was the number of killed or injured? 30,000?
30,000, that was an injured wounded, but right now it's 15,400 dead.
15,400 dead
Russian soldiers.
Yeah, that's a lot.
In under a month, yeah.
And what we heard today was Russian jet number 100 was shot down today. That's what we heard.
I personally wasn't expecting this for Ukraine to do this well in on the air, to tell the truth.
Yeah.
Like, I wasn't, and I'm pleasantly surprised what's going on. Like, with the air defense, tell the truth. So,
for sure.
But again, yeah, like, a lot of misinformation. But again, please check sources. Don't just rely on one. There's plenty of people, like Lovis, who's here and following, like, actually right from here. So it's good to listen to him.
Yeah. So. Paul, do you want to be up there here or something?
Yeah. Okay. I'm enjoying the show.
Yeah. Okay. All right, guys. So the other Ukraine videos are for members only. But I want to put this one out because there's so much misinformation. Oh, the big one. I was going to get here and everyone was going to be a Nazi.
What's that?
The big one was, when I got here, everyone was going to be a Nazi.
A lot of Jewish people.
Yeah.
He was actually
and
just
Jews just left.
Yeah, and they're fighting. All of his family members are fighting.
It's crazy.
Brother's son, like that's exactly what's. Nazis.
lots of people said terrible things about Ukraine, knowing nothing about. But they couldn't find it on a fucking map. And about Ukraine, that don't help them because. You know, the president launders money there. There are people dying here. So what close-minded folks those are, for sure. But we're here. We today was our first day of training. We trained about 30 people, some basic things. We're going to continue that tomorrow. And hopefully make these guys safer for each other and more effective if the time comes. And this is great. And they're helping interpret, and the other guys are helping with everything. It's great.
Yeah, again, and for like locals again, when they see you, like foreigners, like come in, and the morale goes like through the roof.
Yeah.
For them, they are extremely appreciative. They're happy to see you, and they appreciate you.
Yeah.
So that means a lot. Like this is definitely a
when he when Last American Outlaw was making his fucking video, I was quiet. But when I make my fucking video, he's over there running his goddamn cock holster.
That'll be an edit.
No, it won't.
No, you won't be an
edit. This is a fucking video.
You don't know. He's not gonna edit.
We're in our team room right now, and so it's kind of noisy, especially when the guy that stole my video idea, I'm making my idea, I have to sabotage it because. It's better than my shit. Last American Outlaw. You can see Last American Outlaw's copy of this video on his channel right now.
I did it first.
Hey, this is about misinformation. All right, guys, your responsibility to teach Ukrainians how to fight never ends.